Hey guys, and what's going on? It's Max, and I hope you guys are having a wonderful day. But today I'm bringing you a FAMAS nuke on, I cannot remember the map name. To be honest, it's been so long since I played Modern Warfare 2, but big shoutouts to Tempted Swift, aka David, who gave me this gameplay. Links to his channel will be in the description. He also makes beast-ass thumbnails, and he's in the Carnage Clan, so if you guys want to check them out, all the links will lead to his channel, and then you can find your way from there. But thank you so much for the gameplay, and I hope you guys enjoy. I thought it would be nice to put up a Modern Warfare 2 gameplay, seeing as Ghost is right around the corner. It's coming around on Tuesday, so you guys can get really excited about that. But pretty much my topic for today, and I told people on Twitter the topic would be kind of heavy, and it's not for some people, not for, you know, whatever, but I'm gonna try to make it as uplifting as possible. Now, what I based my channel on a long time ago was that I could talk about whatever topic I really wanted to talk about, and whatever was on my mind pressing me right now. And to be quite honest, the thing that has been on my mind, burning on my mind, is relationships with people. They could be intimate relationships, they could be just regular friendly relationships, but the relationships you have with people. Recently I was in a relationship and it didn't work out. It was nobody's fault, but I mean, we kind of just grew apart from each other, and that's what happened. So I've been learning how to deal with that on a daily basis, and my whole precipice on this commentary is not to talk about my relationship, but to talk about relationships in general and what happens when they don't work out, kind of all the emotions that come with it, as well as kind of how to cope with that feeling. It's hard enough for me to kind of sit here and say all this stuff, but I want it to be very objective, and I want it to be kind of uplifting. So now that I've pretty much talked about all that stuff, relationships between people are so important. I don't think people give it enough credit that the people that you talk to on a daily basis, your friends, your family, your significant other, they have a great impact on your life. They truly shape the way that you view the world sometimes, because sometimes their views differ from yours, sometimes they're the same. They give you positive reinforcement when you're down, and sometimes they're the people who even are the negative forces in your life. Those are the type of relationships that people kind of shouldn't have, but they're there, and it's very important. It's part of our human nature to have relationships. That's kind of why we're here, and in my opinion, why we're here on Earth is to have relationships with other people. And it's a healthy experience. It's what everyone goes through. But sometimes those relationships don't work out, and your relationships turn into what people call a relationship. And that's not how my mind ended in any way whatsoever. But it weighs on you personally. You find that inside you may have some sort of heartache, or you may have some sort of sadness. Some guys like to hide it better, and some girls like to hide it better. And other people like me, we wear our hearts on our sleeves, and we express our emotion. And speaking is kind of the way that I express myself, speaking and writing, which is why I love doing commentaries, because whenever I got something on my mind, I just, you know, pump it into a video and then let it flow amongst the masses. But everybody has their different ways on coping with relationships. I've already told you my way to cope, and the important thing is finding different and healthier ways to cope with relationships. Long, long time ago, way back in the day, I was in a relationship that didn't turn out the way that I wanted to, and I didn't know how to find different ways to cope with it. So I sunk into a deep depression. You know, I wore dark clothes, and I didn't go see the light of day, and I stayed inside my room, and it was just a horrible experience. And that truly, that's not what you're supposed to do. If I have spoken from experience enough, it's just to say that if you're going through a rough time, whether it's with your family member or your significant other or somebody else, like a really dear friend of yours, and you guys are going through a rough time or a rough patch, really try to focus on the positives every day in life. I'm not saying it's going to be easy. By no means in this entire world is anything that you will go through easy, but finding little things to kind of put your mind to focus on, to kind of just be that end goal, that's what you should focus on in terms of coping. And then you find other things to do. Sometimes when you end an intimate relationship with someone and you end it, you have to find that the time to kind of fill your day. You have to find those activities. You have to find those the positive reinforcements in your life. You may want to start working out. You know, you may want to maybe start writing. You may want to start speaking. You may want to go on trips, or you may want to just surround yourself with friends, watch movies and stuff. The negative impacts are all of the negative side effects, the depression, the loneliness, the whatever. And it's important. I don't want you to suppress those feelings, or I don't think it's okay for people to suppress those feelings, but you have to learn how to cope with them in a very healthy and positive way. Sometimes I feel like when I talk about my situation, or when I talk about the way that I feel with other people, I feel like I'm dampening their mood a little bit. But at the same time, after we finish talking about it and after we finish conversing, it makes me feel better on the inside. So it's all about finding those people who are willing to listen to your problem. And not only that, but people who are going to take your mind off of it, people who are going to get you involved in doing other things, kind of like that little crutch that you have. I don't see any of my friends as like a crutch per se, but they do help me get my mind off of things. They help me focus on what's right in my life. So what's the plan right now, right? We're taking the negatives and we're making it into positives. So what am I doing working towards my positive goals? Well, I set myself out a goal now that I want to go to PAX, and I want to go to Mardi Gras, and I want to take trips, you know? I want to enjoy my life because I'm very young, you know? I'm turning 21 in 3 weeks. How fucking awesome is that? And that'll be a big blast, big blowout, and lots of other adult stuff that most people don't have to worry about. But those are those little goals that I want to just try to push forward and try to get past all of that stuff. But I kind of want to get you guys' opinion on how you feel about relationships. Now, it could be an intimate relationship, or it could be a non-intimate relationship. It could be a family relationship, something between your mother and father, something between you and your parents. You know, maybe you're estranged from one of your parents, and you wanna know how to cope with that, how to cope with not being close to someone that you used to be close to, or not being close to someone who you really weren't close to at all. And my whole thing, pretty much this entire commentary, is that relationships are important. It's important to keep them happy, and it's important to keep them healthy. And that's what helps you grow as people, you know, because when everybody gets together, honestly, the feeling is so, so great when you have people who love you and who care about you. So let me know in the comment section below how you guys feel about relationships, what you do to cope with them, and kind of what relationships mean to you. But anyways, guys, again, thank you to David for the gameplay, and I hope you guys do enjoy. But I'm pretty sure the game is almost done, probably already dropped his nuke. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Don't forget to check out the links below. I'm Mags. Peace.